22, Business East, North Juniata Street. Take the next right onto West 3rd Street.
Then turn right onto US 522 North.
22 North, East Walnut Street.
Blocks for design for air, so that they've got a framework to support and develop the ideas.
In a quarter mile, take the electric avenue access.
It shouldn't break easily. That was for open. You should be able to open the product, get to the parts, replace them, and get the parts and all that you need to carry out the repair. Balance means that the designer spends the money in the right places. It should have.
Take the electric avenue exit, then merge onto electric avenue.
And it shouldn't have any notable weak points. Use for useful. The product should earn its keep. It should save you time.
Merge onto electric avenue, then turn right onto main roads.
Should make you smile. The sights and sounds of using the product should make you think, wow, this is neat. I want to come back for more. Because then the person is more likely to spend the time and effort needed to carry out the repair. And lastly, T is for transformative. The design should serve an influential field. Should make people think about consuming too much and living in a more sustainable way. And hopefully then they will share their stories.
At the moment, is it easy to repair stuff? I mean, is stuff being built in this way?
In some places it is, in other places it isn't. I mean, there are some very good examples. If you take, for example,
in 60 minutes, the documentary, Warning 10 Babies Born Across the World,
655 exit. Air turn left into Pennsylvania 655 south.
Washington withdrew. Britain's National Gallery has posted its archive and
today with the evident flow of the war in Ukraine. It's flowing for the government in Kiev as Ukrainian forces increase the amount of territory under their control in the Russian region of Kursk. But ebbing as Russian forces continue their seemingly unstoppable advance on the eastern front, edging ever closer to the strategically important Ukrainian town of Pokrovsk, from where civilians are being evacuated. Well, for the second day running, Ukraine has come under Russian missile and drone strikes, targeting its energy infrastructure and cutting off electricity supplies. Sofia is a resident of the capital, Kiev. She told us how the regular power cuts are affecting her.
For me, I have an electric stove, so if there is no electricity, I can't cook any food. Neither do a cup of coffee or tea or anything, so I have to adjust my schedule according to the electricity schedule, which means sometimes cooking at 2 a.m. in the morning for the next day. You don't have electricity, so you don't have a refrigerator, therefore you have to cook on a daily basis, and that depends on the electricity. Laundry is a problem as well, because no electricity for laundry, hot water, or showers because of the boiler. If there is no electricity, you wouldn't be able to have hot shower. The heat wave right now is 32 degrees Celsius in Kiev, so you have to manage to sleep in heat somehow. You wouldn't have Wi-Fi to connect to the world, but also your mobile network is going to be very bad. And banks are not working, all of them, and not properly, so you would go to a branch to withdraw money, or withdraw money away, and they would say there's no electricity, so you'll have to go to another branch that is 30 minutes walk from here, for example. So it does put a challenge on
your daily life,
and you have to adapt, you have to change your schedule, and it does put a lot of frustration.
It was a surfing in Kiev, but President Zelensky was in a relatively upbeat mood in his conference in the capital. He acknowledged the setbacks in the east, but said that newly arrived F-16 fighter planes were starting to make a difference. Well, Ukraine could make even more of a difference if it had permission from Western governments to use long-range missiles they had supplied to fire into Russia.
Already, in this huge attack of Russians, we destroyed already some missiles and drones using the F-16. I won't share how many, but we did it thanks to partners, and they gave us the F-16s provided to us. But again, it's not enough. There's no number of F-16. We have propositions to the United States. It depends on their permission. They have to be positive. Because we speak about our territories, not about the normal territories. Yes, so that's it. And about new package, I'm in favor. I had a conversation with President Biden and decided to give us a new package. Thanks to him, but we have a problem. We need after Biden to bring this package to him.
Let's pick up on some of those words from President Zelensky. He spoke about the incursion into Kursk as being part of a victory plan. He also spoke at another point of presenting a peace plan to U.S. President Biden. Now, I asked the Ukrainian Member of Parliament, Ina Sobson, to tell me more. She's with the Goddess of Horrors Party in Ukraine, with a plan off on their left. She climbed the 14 floors of her apartment building in the north of Kiev and spoke to us.
In 2 miles, take the exit to Railway 322.
Among our building on the Russian lines, and that was in the Kursk region. But the Russians were not holding much troops up there. The Ukrainian army did use that opportunity to break through, which of course does give Ukraine the leverage right now. This is territory we hold on the Russian side under our control right now, and is obviously something that we can use in potential negotiations with Russia if it comes to that.
So when he speaks about the incursion into Kursk as being part of a victory plan, that what he's talking about is perhaps ultimately an exchange of territory with the Russians.
That definitely makes sense. We would be willing to trade their territory for our territory. We never planned to want to do any piece of Russian territory, but we want to have what is ours.
And that territorial exchange, would that form part of the peace plan that Mr. Zelensky says he's intending to present to President Biden?
Well, I don't know the details, but what he did mention, that military situation
22.
To fight, the Russians continue to make advances in the east and are edging closer to the strategically important town of Pokrovsk.
That is indeed the case, and that is a very difficult subject.
What is it for Roman 322?
In the Ukrainian society right now, that it's important to understand that Ukrainians didn't relocate any troops.
In 1,000 feet at the traffic circle, take the first exit onto Old Route 322.
Often the newly used troops are the troops which have been previously used in any less active parts of the front line.
We've been talking about the ground war, but could I just turn to the...
In a quarter mile, turn left at Pennsylvania's 144.
A second day of an intense aerial bombardment from Russia, a drone and missiles, targeting your energy infrastructure. It's not looking good, is it, for the coming months and the winter in particular?
Many explosions from different parts of the city, and definitely the cold was energy infrastructure.
Turn left for Pennsylvania 144, then turn left at Pennsylvania 144.
This, as we are speaking to you right now, I don't have electricity in my place for some hours, as I right now. So I had to climb up the 14th floor that I need one. Now I don't have water at my place, so I have electricity at the moment.
Take the next left to Pennsylvania 144. Continue on Pennsylvania 144 for 2 miles.
Yeah, fixed, but as of right now, station key specifically, is this very bad.
And we've been speaking about your personal anxiety, but you're also a mother with a son, and you need to provide for him as well.
Yes, indeed. And that is something that, of course, is most difficult. But it does make me worry about the upcoming months, especially because I do remember the winter of 2022-23, which was terrible. We have outages for, I think, the longest period I didn't have electricity at my place was 72 hours.
How did you manage that 2022-23?
We had a routine set up. Basically, every night when we came up from school, there was no electricity at our place. So we found several cafes around our place which did have generators, and we would go to our food there, which was quite expensive then, having a meal, but it was worth it. We specifically liked one pizza place. We would go there pretty often, and then when the spring came out, we started going there because electricity was back on. We would have dinners at our place, and so we didn't go to that place. And then I remember one day in the summer, I think my son said, oh, we should go to that pizza place. And I was thinking, okay, we can do that. And the moment I entered that place, my hands started shaking and my heart started bumping, and I couldn't understand why until I realized that this is what PTSD does to me. I was so traumatized by surviving through that terrible winter without electricity that it did form the trauma in my brain. It was very difficult, and that is why I'm panicking when I'm thinking that this is something that we can be through again. And it does seem like that would be the experience of this winter as well.
Ukrainian member of parliament in a subsoil, and just as we were wrapping up the interview, we heard a shout from Inner Sun, who announced that the power was back on. We just have 2 minutes.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto Sinking Creek Road.
CEO of Meta says he bowed to pressure from the Biden administration to censor content on Facebook and Instagram during the coronavirus pandemic. He says the government pressure was wrong, and he regrets not being more outspoken about it. But the White House is defending its actions,
saying it was
responsible actions to protect public health and safety. Republicans, however, have seized on his comments as a win for free speech. The BBC's North American business correspondent in New York, Richard Gupta, described what had led to Mr. Zuckerberg's admission.
A letter to a congressional committee criticizing the Biden Harris administration for what he has described as a censorship. And he said he was pressurized into censoring content about COVID and that he regrets the company's decision to comply with that. Now, if you remember, during the pandemic, Facebook officials, they drew ire he's not going to be making any contributions anyway.
That is BBC's North American business correspondent, Rithika Gupta. Coming up, the property deal that throws into question the whole future of the Armenian quarter in Jerusalem.
This is the biggest existential crisis we face today. So we consider this the last battle for Jews. For the Jews. For the Jews.
Continue on South Pennsylvania Avenue for 1 mile.
Now reporting for later in this edition of News Hour, the latest headlines from the BBC newsroom. Volodymyr Zelensky says Ukraine's expanding incursion into Russia's Kursk region is part of a victory plan that he'll present to President Biden soon. And an Arab-Israeli hostage freed in Gaza after 10 months of captivity has been reunited with his family. We'll also have more details on that story. This is Julian Marshall with News Hour live from the BBC in London. Namibia in southwest Africa is often seen as one of the best countries in the world for wildlife safaris. It's teeming with elephants, hippos, buffaloes, impala and zebras. But it's also a country which at the moment is suffering a severe drought along with the rest of the region. And the Namibian government has announced plans to cull more than 700 animals and to distribute the meat to people who are struggling to feed themselves. But Romy Muyunda is a spokesperson for Namibia's Ministry of Environment, Forestry and Tourism.
Namibia is facing one of the worst droughts in years. This drought is affecting a lot of economic sectors. We know that in a country like Namibia, most people, they depend on subsistence farming. But with the
We
face a situation where most people were unable to get any harvest from their fields or crop fields. It has gone as worse as also affecting livestock, where people do not even have sufficient grazing vegetation for their livestock.
So people are going hungry.
At the light, turn right on Pennsylvania 192 East, East Church Street.
Yes, in most of our national parks, we depend on rainwater for these animals to be able to drink from there.
What animals are
there? Continue on Pennsylvania 192 East, 34 miles.
When you go about it,
we have identified a total of 723 animals. And this is a very small proportion. It doesn't even make 5% of the animal populations that we have. We are going to carry 60 buffaloes. We are going to carry 50 impalas, 300 zebras, 83 elephants.
83 elephants out of our total elephant population, or what?
Our elephant population is estimated.
are some of the most politically fraught on the planet. Emily Wither has been speaking to members of Jerusalem